And welcome back to Channel 9 Live at TechEd North America. I'm Simon Perriman, and I'm joined today by Bradley, who's going to be talking about one of the new features we've just announced, the Windows Azure Pack. But first of all, Brad, what do you do at Microsoft?
Hey, yeah, I'm a program manager actually on the Windows Azure team. And while I'm on Windows Azure, one of the fun things I get to do is work with the Windows Server and the System Center teams on how to deliver our Azure technologies for Windows Server and System Center, AKA the Windows Azure Pack. So I have a lot of fun, that's what I do.
So how exactly are we doing this? How are we integrating Windows Azure between these different components?
You know, that's a great question. Matter of fact, this technology was first introduced kind of in early forms last January. It released in a downloadable form, and we're going big this release at TechEd with the Windows Azure Pack. But it involves several components, from fundamental learnings that came from our Windows experience for building out our Iaas technologies for virtual machines in Azure, and how that learning and experiences went into System Center to provide this new virtual machine role capability, from a management stack, from a set of APIs that would be consistent between Windows Azure and when deployed on a private or hosted cloud, and then a set of management experiences that include portal and usability experiences for how I log in and then consume the set of services that I'm getting from my hosting provider or my IT organization within my company.
So who exactly are your target customers here with the Windows Azure Pack?
Yeah, basically our target customer are those organizations that want to provide cloud functionality to their customers. So that can be an enterprise organization that wants to modernize and provide cloud capabilities to their customers within the organization. These would be customers and developers that want to have a more agile experience, just as they would if they were going to Azure, where they can provision VMs on demand, provision websites that have scale and elasticity to them, or provision databases on demand, or for hosting service providers that want to offer those same kind of cloud services to their customers that can come in and easily provision VMs and websites and databases. And we've also added in this release the Service Bus, which is a great messaging platform for building modern applications.
So I'm not really an Azure guy. Tell me a little more about the Service Bus. What exactly is that?
Yeah, Service Bus is a great messaging platform for building these new loosely coupled systems. If you're building a modern cloud-based application and you need reliable messaging between tiers of applications or between different applications, Service Bus is your solution. So it provides that reliable messaging both in queues and in this relay capability for delivering messages between different tiers of an application, whether it be within the cloud or between the cloud and your on-premise network.
Okay, now how about the websites and the web services? What are we doing with
so,
that?
So you know that about a year ago, we introduced Windows Azure websites, our Azure websites, which is really this new website offering that allows you to have these robust cloud websites that can scale based on demand and have a ton of developer tools built into it, such as support for source code control and Git and publishing, a variety of publishing protocols and development frameworks, whether we're talking about PHP, Node.js, or ASP.NET, intrinsically into the platform. That is our web hosting, our website, a platform that we've built for Azure. That platform is now made available as part of the Azure Pack so that as an IT organization, I can offer these elastic cloud sites for high-density hosting within my organization, or as a hoster, I can offer that same technology that we, Microsoft, run in Azure. I can offer that technology to my customers coming in. So one, I can run that same service with greater efficiency and costing me less dollars, but two, also delivering great value to my customers who want to come in and take advantage of these cloud services.
Okay. Now, I'm a virtualization guy, so I'm excited about some of these VM offerings you have. Tell me a little more about those.
Yeah, VMs is a big deal. Matter of fact, Azure a year ago kind of went into this pre-release of Azure Iaas, or Azure Virtual Machines in Azure. They've now gone GA, so we're now into production with virtual machines in Azure. We've had VMs and Hyper-V on Windows Server and System Center for quite some time now, but what you're seeing is this convergence of our self-service experiences and technologies that we're building for Azure and Windows Server and System Center to provide that same kind of self-service experience for System Center customers, so they can now come in and provision virtual machines just as they would in Azure. They can provision those VMs from a gallery of IT curated applications. And that's really key, because in the enterprise, it's very important to make sure we have a curated set of applications that are IT approved. And matter of fact, I may approve certain applications for one org and a different set for another org. And that is all enabled. So now when I have two orgs coming into my System Center platform with the Azure Pack, each org organization will see a curated set or a tailored set of applications that they can deploy as virtual appliances within their data center. Now, the nice thing is these new virtual machine roles, not only does it allow me to deploy individual VMs, but full-blown applications where I'll have configurations for the VM tiers to allow me to scale from single instance to multi-instance, but as well as having application settings, whether they're SharePoint, database, or Iaas settings. Each application have a unique set of configuration parameters that are determined when I deploy that. And this is also built to take into account the versioning capabilities that are needed for the enterprise. So if my IT organization know there's an update to an application I've deployed, they can publish that available as an operator, as a consumer, an organization getting these services from my IT partner. I can log into the dashboard, I'll see that an update is available, and based on what's happening to my organization, if I'm swamped, I can defer it. If I have a great time in my servicing window, I can choose to deploy that update, and it will be seamlessly rolled out across my application. So that's what we're seeing across VM. Oh, and I want to also tie in is that we have this whole self-service networking capability that's also been exposed to the consumers that come in and get access to my System Center Windows Server infrastructure. My customers can now come in and define their own networks, and a hosting service provider will even allow their customers to bridge their on-premise network into the hosted data center. A lot of cool capabilities coming in the Azure pack with System Center and Windows Server.
Very nice. Well, we have some questions coming in from the audience, and I want to remind our live viewers to go to channel 9 at the bottom of the page, post your questions there, and we'll get to them. But our first question we have from Eddie is, how exactly do you get the Azure pack? How is it licensed? Is it part of Server? Is it part of System Center?
That's a great question. It's actually a standalone license. It is free. We're making this technology available to our partners and our customers to just download along with System Center. When you get the Windows Server or System Center licenses, there's no additional licensing cost for the Azure pack. It is simply an additional set of capabilities that's intrinsically built in to support Windows Server and System Center very natively.
Excellent. And so how soon is it going to be available?
It'll be available the same time Windows Server and System Center R2 is available. So it's on the same wave. And that's one of the exciting things. This isn't like kind of a, when you get Windows Server and System Center, oh, wait, it's coming in a few months. No, we're making this technology available the same time we're making the Windows Server System Center R2 and Windows Server R2 waves available.
Great. Well, can we take a look at it in action?
Sure. I can show you a couple of things real quickly. First thing I want to do, I don't know if we're showing the screen right now.
Yep.
They're able to see? Okay. Yes, you can display right now. I'm just waiting.
All right. So I mean, where are our key capabilities here? We talked about virtualization. We talked about websites. So what are the other key capabilities that we really want to highlight as part of this technology?
Okay, one of the major features that we've added in this release as part of the R2 wave, and this is really done for our enterprise partners, which was a tight integration of Active Directory to the tenant and customer identity system so that they can come in and basically bring their organizational IDs into the management experience. So I can use my corporate identity when I log into the self-service portal to get services that either my IT organization has made available or that a hosting service provider has made available. And that was really key. We've added another of other capabilities for our hosting providers and IT organizations to tailor the set of offers that they're making available to their tenants.
So highly customizable.
Highly customizable for scoping the amount of capacity and the types of services that they have available.
Now, we want to, if you could you try dual project and let's just make sure that we try to get this back up and running?
Okay.
And in the meantime, I'm going to ask, how do we work with service templates? So a virtual machine manager has this concept of service templates where you can basically, create a multi-tier topology of virtual machines. Do we have any integration where you could, scale these pre-configured set of virtual machines?
That's a very interesting question. And it really was, how are we deploying these? What's the integration with the System Center service templates? And I want to key on that a little bit. As part of this release, we're making available these new services that can be deployed across the Windows Server System Center infrastructure as a set of service templates for the back-end operators. But service templates are evolving to support this new concept called virtual machine roles, which really the tenant or customer-facing services that allow them to deploy these applications from a gallery and scale those on demand. And this is really kind of an evolution of the Azure virtual machine capabilities and the System Center service templates all coming together to provide a great end-user experience.
Great. Now, one of the other key system center components people are really getting excited about is Orchestrator. Building automation, what type of integration points will this have once it's released with Orchestrator?
One of the things coming up in this release, and as part of this, is a deep integration with System Center orchestration as part of the Windows Azure Pack. And the Windows Azure Pack really has two components. It has the customer-facing experience. We think of this as the consumer view for those customers that want to come in and consume cloud services. We also have a provider view. This is designed for IT operators and hosters who basically run cloud services. And as part of that experience that we're building with System Center for operators, we've got a deep engagement and set of experiences around orchestration. So I can go in and author my runbooks as part of the provider portal and actually manage those workflows as they're running in my data center. So a very deep integration with Orchestrator.
Now, how about Service Manager? A lot of people are starting to use Service Manager to, you know, do the ITIL, manage their data centers, their resource. Do we have any integration there? So as people make requests, you know, we could go tie that in.
These really are, right now, these are two separate offerings. They are compatible in the sense that they both can cooperate on the same environment, but one is really intended for self-service from a subscription point of view. The Azure Pack really brings this concept of cloud subscription to the forefront, where I, as a consumer, have a subscription to a set of cloud services that are made available and managed by my IT operator. And the Service Manager is focused at a kind of traditional IT workloads and self-service in that aspect. And these worlds are converging, and right now they are compatible and both running on the same infrastructure, but they're kind of catering to two separate sets of experiences.
Okay, great. Now, what about the release version? Will this support earlier versions of Windows Server, earlier versions of System Center, or is this built purely on the R2
This products? Is really built for the R2 wave. So This is intended to be a first-class experience as part of the R2 wave, and it is part of that release. So to deploy the Windows Azure Pack, you'll need the R2 technologies that go with it.
Great. Now, as we wrap up, is there any other information that you'd like to share, any other key points?
I really would encourage to stay tuned. There's a bunch of sessions coming out this week that are going to be introducing these concepts, a number of deep dives. You'll see a lot of great demos and walkthroughs of this technology covering websites, service bus, and some great demonstrations for virtual machines and Iaas. So I encourage you to take a look. This is really fun technology, and if you've ever wanted the opportunity to run Azure technology and services in your data center for your customers, this is the technology that will help you do it with Windows Server and System Center.
Now, do we have any public documentation with any details about this? Or are these TechEd sessions going to be the best place for people to learn
more? The TechEd sessions really are the best places to go. You can actually get a preview, view of what was previously released and known as Windows Azure Services for Windows Server that was released in January. You can go take a look at that. And that was kind of the first incarnation of this, but the Azure Pack has a very deep and well-integrated set of experiences with a lot of new capabilities, and that's where I really would encourage everyone to take a look at what we're bringing to the R2 wave.
Excellent. Well, thanks so much for your time. I mean, the Azure Pack looks like a great product. I'm sure we're going to see a lot of rapid adoption once this hits RTM. Now, please stay tuned. Up next is Jeff Woolsey, and we're going to be covering A Taste of TechEd. Once again, thanks, Bradley.
Thanks.